This particular truck came in with a brake noise. Now the noise is coming from the backing plate. The shoes rubbing against the backing plate was never lubricated. So we're gonna take everything apart, clean everything, clean the backing plate and lube it. And the owner of the truck decided to go ahead and put new shoes on right away. They're not really needed, but he said, as long as you got it all torn down, we're gonna go ahead and put new hardware on and new shoes also. So let's get started. Step number one is to remove these return springs. Now there's a special tool for this. Don't try to do this with a pair of pliers. These springs are pretty strong. They're under some pretty good tension. Make sure you wear safety glasses also, because things can slip off, spring can slip, but watch how easy it is with this tool. Slide in here and just get behind that spring, work it right off. Same thing with this spring right here. There you go. The next thing we're gonna remove is the hold down springs. Now I've got the new one here to show you. What that is, there's a pin coming through, there's a spring on it, but this little piece right here, as you can see, slides over, and then you turn it to lock it in place. That's in the lock position right there. Now what we have to do is we have to depress it and turn it so that we can slide it off of that pin, that hold down pin right there. Right like that. So I've got another special tool for that we can grab it. Sometimes I have to reach behind and hold the pin to keep it from turning, but watch. Pops right off. There's one more to do on this side. This one's a little bit harder. She doesn't want to turn, but we'll get her. There it goes. Now that one's off. One more tip when you're doing brake shoes on any vehicle, only remove one side at a time. Now, I know where these springs go. I've done many of these brakes on Chevy trucks, but if you're doing a vehicle that maybe you're not real familiar with, and you take it all apart and you have the springs in a pile and then you do the other side, it's very hard sometimes to find a good picture of what you just did. Now, some people take a picture before they start, take a picture after with your phone, that's not a problem at all. In fact, it's a nice thing to show the customer what you've actually done to their vehicle. Now that we have the return springs and the hold-on springs off, now we're gonna take the shoes off together. That's just the way I've always done it. So we'll take this off together. One more thing we'll take off here to help us out a little bit is right here. Now, when I take this off, I just spread this, take it right down, and that's both my brake shoes. Now, this right here is my self-adjuster. I have one more spring here. In fact, they have another spring here. Yeah, this one I don't have to take off quite yet. This one here I will take off when I finally separate it. But as you can see, I have to do one more thing yet. I have a pin right here for my parking brake. So I have to pry that pin off, that retainer, the little C-clip, and then I'll have to actually can pull it away from the unit.